it was a little bit of a fashion in those days to kind of record somewhere else. So I knew EMI had a lot of studios. So I said to the guy, I said, could you give me a list of where you've got studios? And I looked down, this list was very exciting. It was like Rio de Janeiro. China was a possibility. And then I saw they had one in Lagos. So I thought, oh, Lagos, man, you know, Africa. I loved African music and beats. And I thought, okay, if I go to Rio, we're gonna pick up maybe a Latin feel. But I thought, but if we go to Lagos, we'll pick up a sort of rhythmic African feel. I think I overplayed the idea, because when we actually got there, I pretty much made the record I wanted to make. But that's what it was. I just looked at the list and thought, wow, Africa, Lagos, adventure. Let's do it. Right the night before we were due to fly the next morning, a couple of the guys rang me up and just said, oh, we're not coming, you know. Drummer Denny and Henry, the guitar player, said, we're not coming, you know. I never quite worked out why, whether they just thought Africa's a bit far, a bit crazy. But it was wild times, but that was why I went to Lagos. It just sounded exotic.
Okay, chaps.
Funny out there, Africa, you know, they make great music, but they're not as technologically savvy as we were. We expected it to be a proper EMI studio, I think EMI they built one. But in fact, we said, okay, where are the vocal booths? You know, kind of want to go do the vocal, and the guys have looked at me blank. So we had to say, okay, well, here's what it is. You take bits of wood, and you make a big box, and we drew it out and gave them the dimensions. But we got it done, you know, and I think the kind of vibe of it being a little bit homemade, certainly the studio was homemade, that kind of found its way into our attitude. It was a little like, okay, look, if we haven't got a vocal booth, we'll just do it this way. And we adjusted our recording techniques till we did have a vocal booth, and we said, now we can do the vocal. If you have the ability to do a remastering, it's great to do, but there's always going to be some people say, well, yeah, but why are you doing it again, you know? So, yeah, on the new stuff, we've got some interesting additions.